touch anything, Casper. I'll be right back, okay? Touch.
Hey, Gramps.
You know, you won't believe it. The annual Occultist Society Awards are tonight.
Wow, great.
I originally RSVP'd that I was going to go on account of the shop. One of the organizers just called and said, I have to go because they're giving me a lifetime achievement award with a trophy and everything. Can you believe it? My very first trophy.
Wow, congrats, Gramps.
The only thing is, I need somebody to watch the shop while I'm away.
What about Mom?
She's working. And other than her, you're the only family I got. What do you say, kiddo?
Sorry, Gramps, I can't. I've got football practice.
Oh?
Yeah, I'm kind of the glue that holds the team together, so.
All right. I guess I can always use my trophy case to store my very sad-looking tribal masks. Good luck with the footballs.
Thanks, Gramps. Bye.
Yeah, bye.
It's a beautiful sunny day today, folks. The type of day when nothing
football, Casper? Really?
I saw nightmares, Ma. You know, I haven't been in there since...
I know, sweetheart. I know it's hard, but it's been 15 years.
Can you close the shop for like a day or two? It'd be...
Your grandfather can't close the shop during business hours. You know that.
I just can't, okay? It's so cursed in there.
Sweetheart. Oh, honey. Don't forget your lunch. And remember what I did with the crusts. I cut them like you like them. Go home. Be a good boy.
Don't forget to put your belt on.
I'll be fine, Mom.
Okay, sweetie. Bye.
Bye. You never get nervous anymore.
So wait up.
However, when the eagle eats the ferret, it's hard not to extrapolate the sexual undertones. Very creative writing, Missy.
Thanks, Mr. Duffy. I heart eagles.
Oh, that's creative, too. Mr. Galloway, how nice of you to grace us with your clumsy presence.
Good one, sir.
It's a really cool sketchbook.
I doodle with pencil.
Okay.
Doodle with pencils.
All right, class, for the next 15 minutes, I want you to write a poem about a jealous shark.
I think it'll be exciting.
Oh, my God, Casper, did I just see your pinky finger touch Charlotte's knee?
Not for information, Becky. She said my notebook was cool.
Why don't you just ask her out? Oh,
I'm sure Patrick and his ginormous muscles would love that. They're so big.
It's better than being a weird guy that just draws sketches of his crush.
It's coming from the girls dating Bert, the TA. Bert, really? What's up with that?
Maturity and a mutual love of poetry, my friend.
Maturity, mm-hmm. Yes. The guy that wrote you a poem comparing your hair to hot dogs. Is that guy?
Yeah. And?
And that's ridiculous.
Bert, do we have Mr. Galloway's end of term assignment yet?
No, sir.
Just as I thought. Do you realize you have not handed in your end-of-term assignment yet, Mr. Galloway?
Yeah, I realized. I realized it because I have it here. I'm just, tweaking a few things.
Yeah, right.
Writing is rewriting, Professor Duffy.
If it's not on my desk by tomorrow, I will fail you.
I'm on it.
I'm screwed.
I know.
And for the love of God, stop it with your incessant doodling! I don't like doodling. I never told you I like doodling. I never wrote you a note saying I like doodling. I never doodled you a doodle saying I like doodling. Stop doodling.
I don't have a clue what to write. I'm going to flunk out of college and live with my mother for the rest of my life. She's going to be making meatballs, and I'm going to be eating them at age 75.
Casper, just write anything. Look, I wrote a one-act play entitled The Feminist Snail. Duffy gave me an A.
What?
Check it out, friends of mine. This puppy is a 1970s original mint condition.
Seth, you're the only guy I know that can actually sell mugs and make money online.
Sell and barter. Last week I got a Winnebago.
For mugs?
Antique mugs. Tonight I got a massive shipment going out to the Polish Mug Society.
Mugs are hip, Casper.
Heck yes, they are. My online mug business is booming. After graduation, I am going to make buckets of money. Cass, what are you doing after graduation?
I don't know! That's crazy!
But tonight, my love, I was thinking some 18th century poetry and a little Japanese Chardonnay. They go beautifully together.
Until then?
Oh, the minutes will feel like daggers to my eyes.
Bert, hey! Hey, man, I got a thing you need to own.
Yeah, what's that?
Never know when you're gonna need a hot dog mug.
Hot dog mug.
Yes.
How much?
I can give you the one-time low price of $100.
I got 80.
I'll cash. Take that. Thank you.
Hi, daggers, Mikey. Hi, daggers. Trots. Bye-bye, boys.
See you, Bert.
Bert.
Man. Oh, check it out. There's the trophy for the big grudge match tonight. I remember my very first trophy. Greatest day of my life. Most improved hygiene.
True story.
It's really gross. Hey, man, I smell amazing now.
Castman, what's up with you?
Oh, it's that trophy guy back there. Graham's supposed to be getting a trophy tonight, and he asked me to watch the shop for him.
What?
Really? What'd you say?
I said I have football practice.
Can you believe that?
Hey! Hey, why are you laughing? I'm a great football player. I can hold my own when it comes to the pig skin.
Incoming!
Oh, ow! Ow, my arm!
Nice catch, Casper.
I caught it.
Picture.
Make sure you post that shit, Becky.
Will do.
Oh, hello, nurse. I am in love with Lucy Winthrop.
Should have heard her Eagle poem. It was full of sexual undertones.
I bet.
Hey, Daz. You got your arm ready for the big game tonight?
Touchdown's my middle name, babe.
Good. Because I hate the Wildcats.
Hey, Lucy.
Oh, get bent, loser.
You will be mine.
Oh, he's so annoying. I know.
Watch it, cheese bread.
Hey, Dad, you want to take home that trophy tonight, you better make sure you get the ball to the paddy wagon, you know what I'm saying?
Are you drunk, Patrick?
Oh, screw you, too. Hey, think quick, Galloway.
No!
Okay, man. Lay off. Chill out, Dads. All right, I'm just messing around, you know, Dad? Come on, ladies. Let's make like a baby and head out. The chair that waits.
Bye, Lucy.
Bye, Lucy.
Hey, man. We're like family. That's what we do. Take care of each other.
Family.
We're like brothers.
And on that note, who wants burritos?
I do.
Seth is paying.
Hey, you chuck that hot sauce they have, and I'll get you whatever you want.
You got a deal, baby.
I'm coming, Cass.
You know what? You guys go. I got stuff I have to do.
Suit yourself.
Hey, Gramps.
Hey, Carol. What are you doing here? I thought you had the footballs.
Dislocated my appendix. And besides, we're family. A brother's got another brother's back.
You gotta watch the shop.
If it helps you out.
That's great news.
Yeah.
It's not every day you get a lifetime achievement award from the Occultist Society.
Okay.
Let me give you the nickel tour and explain the ground rules. One, never close during open hours. Two, make sure you lock up when you leave. And three, absolutely, under no circumstances is anyone to come within spitting distance of that urn. Understand?
Yeah, I certainly do.
Let me tell you a story. Your great granddaddy, Gilbert Galloway, captured evil spirits.
So he was like a Ghostbuster.
More like a demon shit kicker.
Oh, shit.
And that there urn contains the remains of the most malicious and evil spirit of them all.
What happens if it breaks?
The spirit would curse whomever released it, that's what. You gotta treat that thing with respect, or it'll make your life a living hell. But don't you worry, kiddo. You're safe. As long as you don't mess with it.
Okay.
Well, I gotta go.
So soon? Really?
Hello. Long drive ahead of me. Go deep.
It's my appendix. Broke.
Remember the rules, and you'll be fine. Meets the world, Casper.
Perhaps I got it under control. I can't do this. Helmet! No!
Find him. We'll just be a second. First, we need this.
Is that Charlotte? You bike wearing a mouth guard as well, huh? Really? Me too. I do. I know it's embarrassing.
Casper?
Oh! Hi.
What are you doing here?
Working. Just, I'm not working hard, though, if that's not cool. I'm just taking it cool, because I'm Mr. Cool Beans.
You work here?
Yeah, taking care of it for my gramps.
Oh, Caspi, of course. Your grandfather talks about you all the time.
Guys?
I'm in here a lot. I think this stuff is so cool.
Yeah.
How come I've never seen you here?
Like, never?
Ever.
Oh, you know what? Probably in the back, working with the really scary stuff.
Are you sure? This place is gross. Okay. I just have to pay for the book.
You know what? It's on the house.
No.
Yes.
What?
Yeah. You can consider it an appreciation gift for the very faithful customer of the occult barn.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Good day, sir. I will take 3 buffalo testicles, please.
Hey, Lucy, talk about fate. We're meant to be together.
As if.
Guys, what do you,
What, you think we're gonna leave you alone in your most feared place on the planet? Come on, man.
Feared? By feared, you mean favorite. That's what you mean, right?
Favorite. Right. That's what I meant to say.
Casper, man, how much your grandfather want for that cool mug thing? That would catch me a mint online. No, that is not a mug. That is an urn, and it's a do not touch, do not sell item.
Oh, come on, man. Everything's negotiable.
No, not that. That's not negotiable.
It should be.
It's not going to be.
Well, it will be in my books.
Never.
$50?
No.
Okay.
I think it's really cool.
You do? Really?
Oh, yeah. I've asked your grandfather about it, but he always just changes the subject.
I don't know why he does that.
Hey, Char, are we going or what?
Yeah, in a second. Casper was just about to show us this really cool urn thing.
I was.
Well, shit or get off the pot, man.
Patrick, you're a jerk.
I can't.
Oh. Thanks for wasting my time. Sack breath. Let's peel, ladies.
Wait, no. I meant...
I can't let you go without seeing it.
Really?
Sure.
Yay!
All right, careful, Casper. You're not the most athletic.
Don't slip.
Yep, but
I've been waiting so long to see this.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Careful,
Caspi. Good. Hurry up,
Polo. Smile.
Easy, Pecky. This thing's dangerous. Jeez.
Oh, it's a wicked picture, though.
Can I touch it?
Okay.
All you need is a broom and some sticky tape. I can fix that no problem.
We're all cursed, Seth!
Oh, sure we are.
Yeah, good one, Casper.
No, seriously, we are. That urn contains an evil spirit, and when it breaks, it escapes and curses you.
You mean an evil curse, like we walk out of here and everyone we make eye contact with is going to kill themselves and then come back as a zombie?
That is a horrible thing to say. It's a horrible thing to say.
Zombies are so overdone.
Not just any old zombie, Becky. I'm talking about a zombie possessed by the ash demon from the urn.
What?
Oh, wait, so then it's half a zombie, half.
A.K.A. Zeman.
Right.
This isn't a joke, guys.
You're a joke. Wait, instead of eating your brains, they give you hickeys.
Yes!
Right?
Yeah, what? And then if they hickey you, you'll want to kill yourself too, and then if you do, you will also turn into a Zeman.
Obviously.
That doesn't even make sense.
And there should totally be a rule that you can seduce them, and if you give them a French kiss, then they become your slave.
Oh, I'm liking the old fixation theme.
I think that everything should just start at midnight tonight.
Oh, Seth, come on with the cliches.
Okay, how about 10?
Yep. No, yep. 10 works for me.
I can clear my schedule. Yeah,
we got football. 10, that's too early. 10 works.
Oh, and if we don't reverse the curse by dawn, we'll be cursed for eternity.
It's gotta be eternity.
Yes.
This is a wicked curse.
Okay.
That's a terrible curse.
Hands in.
All right.
1, 2, 3.
Curse! Ah! Lightning!
This is so awesome.
Oh, man.
You're being weird.
We need to build a barracks or find a bomb shelter or something.
You're weird, man.
No.
Yeah.
No.
We need to calm down.
Okay, everyone out. Out, out, now.
Calm down, Caspi. It's okay.
No.
Don't cry.
I'm not crying. I'm sweating in my eyes. That's all.
Anyway, now.
Bye, Casper.
See you later, Casper. Yes,
Caspi, nothing's going to happen, okay? It would be cool if it did, but nothing ever does, so. Thank you again for the book.
No problem.
Bye.
Oh! I'm really sorry, Mr. Evil Urn Ashman. I'm going to fix up your little house in no time.
There you go, Mr. Terrifying Evil Ash Spirit Man. I told you I'd fix up your little house, huh? Get his new. That's it.
This time. We will end it. This life ain't got no fuse. Don't say it's not my business. It's tragic, you don't
Din-din ready.
No time! First!
Oh, it's homemade meatballs!
Where does a man find a hammer in this house, Mother?
Under the sink, honey.
Oh.
I'm so happy. Your grandfather called today and he told me how proud he was of you that you stopped by the shop. You are such a good boy, sweetheart. Casper? Casper?
Whoa. What is it, Becky? Oh, I'm about to blow my barracks before 10 hits. What are you doing? You're going on a date! Imminent doom is upon us here, Becky! Imminent doom! Don't you... How am I supposed to know what color lipstick is better? I don't... Just go with red. Fine, go with electric fuchsia! I don't care about your lipstick problems! No eye contact after 10, okay? Hey, hello?
No eye contact, no Zeman's.
Ow.
Barracks complete. Oh, good. Only 9 minutes.
Whoa! Jets! I need supplies!
Can I have enough? Oh, great Lord.
Your grandfather's on the
Hey, Greg!
Hey, kiddo. How's your makeout today?
Oh, so awesome. Yep. Nothing bad happened, that's for sure.
Oh, that's swell thing to hear. It's so awesome, too. My great, trophy.
Great, huh? Congrats, Gramps! I just gotta go ice my appendix. Here's my love you, bye.
Why, Emily? Fragile and weak. Until I see you, my mighty you. If I could don a cloak made of the love of thee, then I, as a leaf, could tip over my tree.
It's brilliant.
Really, I'm thinking of changing the leaf part to a more fragile metaphor. Anyway, to start.
I wouldn't change a thing.
Really? Mm-hmm. Thank you. How about we take the party to the balcony, huh? I light up the tiki torches.
No matter what's took, no matter what's given, I always want more, son, because this is how I'm living.
Christian Hansen
is... The annual grudge match is well underway, and the Christians are back in the red zone. Will they hand it off to the paddy wagon and go in and get the trophy? We'll find out. The fans are going crazy, and look at that guy,
Sean. Food ration check, toilet paper check. Oh, I have TP, but no latrine.
I need latrine! Ma, where's the mop bucket? Ma!
Walk and roll.
No!
Are you on the weed, Casper?
How are you feeling, Ma? Nauseous? You're suicidal?
Don't change the subject. Are you on the weed?
No, I'm not. I'm not on the weed.
Then why are you making messes and acting like a drug user?
Something bad happened at the shop today, but... the fact that you haven't killed yourself is, it's great.
Don't even joke like that, Casper.
Sorry.
That's great, sweetie. We'll talk about it after my bath. Love you, sweetie.
Yeah. Love you, Ma.
Would it be presumptuous of me to say that I'm falling head over heels in love with you?
Wow. I wouldn't say presumptuous so much as premature. I am moving away after graduation.
Too soon. Yeah. It's the wine talking.
It's okay.
Wow. With that, I'd like to propose a toast.
Okay.
To my beloved Becky, and to the beauty of every moment we spend together. And with that, I bid you adieu.
Adieu. Adieu.
I don't know why I did it!
Oh, God. Kevin.
Oh.
Time to shine, Tony. Both of you want to, okay?
Watch your ass.
all this time, baloney bread. Never drop
it. Okay.
And here we go.
Told you we're not per speech, Becky.
Everything okay in there? Ma? Something, Ma, coming in, and that could get weird.
Please. Oh, dang. Oh, dang.
let it be a bee in pajamas.
We're real sorry, mister.
Oh my God. She came out of nowhere.
Don't mind the shotgun. We was just duck hunting. It's a 12 gauge.
Pastor, here. I got a serious hankering for some buckshot. This feels right.
No!
No!
Oh, Becky, it's so good to see you. Oh, Mom turned into Zeman, and I ran, and now she's dead.
Oh, my God.
God.
Casper, I'm so sorry.
What's with the crossbow?
Bert, I don't know exactly what he is, but you were right. We're definitely cursed.
I knew this would happen.
What about the others?
The game.
What?
The game! First, we all gotta come to grips with exactly what's going on here.
Meaning?
We're cursed.
I'm so sorry we didn't believe you, Casper. So, everything we said at the shop is actually happening.
I don't even remember what we said.
Whoever we make eye contact with is going to kill themselves, come back as Zemans, and try and kill us via hickeys.
Whose dumb idea was hickeys?
My bad.
But don't forget, you can French kiss them and make them your slave. My bad.
I'm gonna go poop.
He was with his mom at 10 o'clock.
Oh.
Zeman, Dad! Kill it! Sorry, Seth, I thought you were Zeman.
No, guys, it's just Brain Freeze Central. Lucy's in my apartment? Wait, is this an intervention?
Where have you been, dude?
I just had to go and ship my package. Package.
Tell me you kept human contact to a minimum.
Well, as luck would have it, after I mailed my package out to the Polish Mug Society, I ran into this hot chick who asked me for directions. I think she was Swedish. And then I found this guy selling stolen stereos on the side of the road out of a van. He gave me a great deal on a set of speakers. And then I earned some brownie points by helping this old lady cross the road. Dad, she was a total gilf.
Gilf?
Yeah. You know, a granny I like to...
Oh, no.
Okay. Well, then I filled up my mug with a delicious slurp slurp. Red, of course. And then I had a funny conversation with the store clerk guy about how gross those salsa pretzels are. And then I came home.
You saw that many people on your way to mail a package?
Oh, yeah, I almost forgot. When I was in the store, this hippie dude came in and he actually bought one of those gross salsa pretzels. And then we got to chatting about mugs and stuff, which led to this impromptu double Dutch session with this friend of his named Tito. And then we smoked a huge fatty. And then I came home.
And how many of those people did you make eye contact with?
Well, I mean, everyone, of course. Eye contact's an important character trait. Hey, man! No, no, guys, it's cool. It's one of the hippie dudes I was telling you about. Hey, man, you're so baked, you're like almost blue. Hey, these are the merchandise, guys!
Smoke!
Super who?
There's a dragon's here!
Oh, man, no, please.
The head was a good choice. Thanks.
The curse is real, isn't it?
Yeah, man. And we gotta move. Now.
I say we hit up Gramps' shop. He's gotta have books that can help.
There's no way I'm going back to that rat shack.
Now is not a good time to be typical, Patrick.
Oh, look at that! Maybe we should go.
Do you still have that Winnebago you traded for mugs?
Seth! Listen. Where are the keys to the Winnebago?
On the desk?
Desk.
Got him!
Everybody grab a weapon! It's a game of inches!
Fixing things won't bring back Mom.
I know.
No, I don't.
We can do this. Okay? Now pick up that rolling pin and get ready to flatten some Zeman ass like a real man.
What about Seth?
He's in the van with everybody else.
I'm gonna bring some tissues.
Good on you.
As hard as I can.
Could you just lay off him, Patrick?
Whose side are you on, Shark?
Yeah. Look it down.
Ha! Gramps! What are you doing here?
I came home to put up my trophy. What happened to the urn?
It broke.
No kidding. This is bad.
I knew it was bad.
But manageable.
Oh,
good.
That's real good.
Lock the door! I'm getting good at this.
What the heck is that?
That's a Zeman.
You better tell me exactly what happened when you broke the urn.
Okay, so we sort of made a joke about a curse that involved us looking at people, and when we did, they killed themselves and came back as zombie demons.
AKA Zemans.
Oh, and don't forget the hickeys.
Danielle, yeah, if we don't reverse it before sunrise, then we're cursed for eternity.
You mocked the spirit!
To be fair, sir, we actually thought we were mocking Casper, your grandson.
A curse is no laughing matter!
Our bad. Sorry.
Whatever you said, when the last ash hit the ground, it's gonna happen.
I knew it was bad.
This book can help. This is spirit. It burned the new curse rules into the world.
That is so cool.
It's so shiny.
Complicated.
Get the book. There's still a hole.
Somebody do something! CPR! I'm like anything!
So...
we got company!
In there, Gramps.
Your great-granddaddy. It's in
here. It is what? What?
You got it. Dig.
Dig where?
You got it. Dig.
Gramps. No! Gramps. No!
Casper, we gotta move him before he turns into a zebra. We'll make this right, buddy.
Sorry, Cas.
Okay, where are we gonna put him? I got an idea. What do we got?
Look familiar?
Yes.
That urn contained an evil spirit that haunted these parts during the turn of the century.
And it was finally captured and contained by none other than Casper's great-grandfather.
He was a hero, Casper.
He was a hero, Casper?
Hero Schmiro, can we fix this shit?
Yes, we can, but we have a lot to do before sunrise.
Our mission's in 6 hours and 13 minutes.
Okay, so... capture the spirit again. We need to recreate the urn by gathering the following elements. Okay, so first we're gonna need ashes from the previous urn.
Ashes. Got it.
Oh, great. Okay. We need a new urn to capture the spirit.
Oh, I think I saw something over there.
Okay, great. Okay. Next up, we need a human skull to seal the urn and a toad heart to bring it to life.
Check and check.
Really? You know where to find a human skull?
Anthroclast, Patrick. If you can, you know.
Okay, all right. Next up, we need a timepiece from the previous exorcist of the spirit.
Exorcist, that must be Casper's great-grandfather.
Yeah.
Any ideas?
His name's Gilbert Galloway. That's all I got.
That's something. We can research the name at the library.
Looks like we're headed back to campus.
Oh, I thought that place was useless.
You can check Ernie off the list.
The door!
Looks like this one's a gold digger.
Okay.
We need more weapons.
Okay, just take your pick.
I am what you're saying.
Okay.
These are my guns. These are my bullets.
Guys, bracelet that I found. Yeah, Gramps, let me try these ones. There used to be four.
Don't stop me.
We have to stick together.
Let's go, Charlotte.
What? No, I'm not gonna leave.
Look, I know tonight's been tough. Okay, but I say we drop the dead weight and we save ourselves. We can get a fresh start. Just you and me, just like the old days. What do you say?
Are you delusional? Patrick, this isn't ninth grade anymore. Why would I go anywhere with you after how you acted tonight?
You'll forget about it. You'll forget about us. Okay? You've made it pretty clear whose side you're on.
Wait, this isn't about sides, Patrick.
Oh, sure it is. And I'll make it easy for you. You can stay here with your new pussy friends while the paddy wagon moves on to greener pastures. Peace.
I wouldn't do that.
Oh, shut up, horse breath. See how far you get without a leader like yours truly.
Patrick, please don't do something stupid.
Patrick? Patrick, where's it going? Patrick! You're kidding me.
And for the record, Char, the only reason I stayed with you so long was the thought that I convinced Lucy to have a threesome with us.
What? Oh,
farewell, bitches!
Oh,
oh
my God!
No! Charlotte!
Does this mean you're single?
Seth! It's not funny.
Too soon.
Yeah, of course it does.
That's my thought, though. No, sort of.
Guys. No.
Wait. You guys hear that?
What? No.
Why are we stopping?
Bad news, guys.
For the record, guys, if I'd known we'd be involved in a Zima curse tonight, I would have totally topped up the tank.
Okay. Oh, it's isolated. There's one guy working the joint. He's half asleep watching TV.
Guys, did you happen to notice any snacks?
Honestly, Seth?
Guys, I got the munchies big time.
Okay, let's push.
All right,
get
one.
The pumps. Ready?
One, two, three.
In breaking news, emergency rooms are filling up with reports of self-inflicted injuries in the east end of town.
Perfect.
But now, back to the music.
Just so you know, I'm not so great in these sort of situations.
We just gotta play it cool. Give him $20 for gas. Avoid eye contact. Get out. No biggie.
Okay. Nobody is gonna be able to see my eyes through this thing.
Here's hoping.
Yeah. Whew. All right. Okay.
There's our cue. Watch my back. Well, hello. Good evening, sir. We will take 20 in gas, please.
Nice camper.
Oh, yeah. You're telling me. God, purrs like a kitten.
Need a price check on these?
Oh, wow. You know what? I think I already have those in purple, so...
These are really small for my face. I can't...
I don't want them.
How funny it is.
Oh, wow. Oh, yikes. I got something in both my eyes right when you did that.
My
That's
eyes
a coincidence.
Also are stinging.
Both of them.
Stinging. Yeah, I'm sorry.
My motor oil exhibit!
Oh, no. Oh, sorry.
Goddamn kids have no respect for history.
No, don't go out now.
Time for plan B.
We have plan B?
No.
Oh.
Hey, clean up your mess, huh? Open heart, Seth.
Jesus. Casper.
Your hand. Step to my back, you little freaks. Get out of here.
You little... Thanks for the gas, man.
That didn't hurt. Shut it. Go. Shut.
But mission accomplished.
Yeah, since I accidentally made eye contact with the guy, but I was wearing the mask, so it should be fine, right?
Guys?
Tackle the biology lab, get to Todhart. Charlotte and Becky get to the library, find out as much about Gilbert Galloway as you can. Casper, stay here, man the Winnebago.
Perfect. What about the skull?
I know exactly where my anthropology prof keeps it.
We should stick together. I have a bad feeling about this.
No, Casper, we stick to the plan.
College is going to be swarming with Siemens from the football game. We all know what happened when Patrick went off on his own.
We don't have time, Casper.
Don't say it in court.
What is that supposed to mean?
Nobody listened to me with the urn. Look how that turned out.
Come on, that's not fair.
Yes, it is fair. I didn't even want to take the urn down in the first place.
Wait, are you blaming me?
It's not what I meant.
Let's go back
in. Wait.
It's not what I meant! That's not what...
You make me sick.
Hey, just cool it, man. We'll be back in no time.
It's not what I meant.
Sick.
Would you ever dissect a toad before?
No.
Oh, it's actually kind of fun, huh?
Oh, I just puked in my mouth.
I'm telling you, after what we've been through tonight, it'll seem like a bowl of cherries. I promise.
I'd probably just screw it up.
Well, that's impossible because you're perfect.
Really?
Yeah. In every way. Just pop that cherry.
Okay.
Okay, so as soon as that's finished printing, we'll head back to the Winnie and brainstorm over what we've got.
Okay, sounds like a plan. You know, Casper really didn't mean what he said back there. He was just venting.
No, I know. The poor guy. He's already lost his mother and his grandfather tonight.
Yeah.
What about Casper's dad?
Oh, God. He died right in front of him when Casper was a kid. Yeah, it happened right at the cult barn. Hence Casper's jumpiness in life and his sheer terror towards his grandfather's shop.
Oh, wow. That explains a lot.
Is that a crow? Or an eagle? Radio will calm me down.
Everybody's dead! They're all dead!
Nope, no. Ooh.
Holding up Patrick and everything.
You know, I've been trying to find a way to break up with him for so long. I never imagined it would be so horrific.
Let's get out of here before something horrific happens to us.
Okay.
I'll grab the paper. I'll watch the door.
Oh, yeah. Voila. A toad hurt.
It's so tiny.
I know. Right. Thank you. You are humongous.
Josh?
What a surprise, Mr. Galloway. Doodling away in an unauthorized parking zone.
Oh, Professor Duffy, what are you doing here?
I'm here marking papers and couldn't help but notice that yours still wasn't in the pile.
Listen, you're in serious danger, okay? You need to go home, lock your doors, lock your windows, hide your dog.
Is this another feeble excuse as to why you haven't handed in your assignment?
No, sir.
Good, because I will fail you. Hey, look at me when I talk to you.
Trust me, you don't want that.
I said, look at me, I am your elder, even though I do look good for my age, granted.
I will never look at you. I will never, ever look at you.
Are you on the weed, boy?
No! Okay, it's just weed, not the weed. Why do all you old people have to say that?
Good. Now, I just want you to move this vehicle to an authorized parking zone.
Sir, listen, I'm gonna need you to think happy thoughts, okay?
Will do. Gotta go! Not sure where, but I'm leaving!
No! No, Duffy! Wait!
Okay. Let me handle this. It's time to seduce a slave. Hey, Joshy. Have seen and date. You. Pucker up, big boy.
I'm not sure this is a good idea.
It's working.
Is it?
It's working. Touch your nose.
Time to hit the showers, big boy.
Why'd you do that, Seth? He could have totally been our slave.
I'm not gonna let no Zeman slave Mac on my girl.
He said I'm your girl.
You're thinking those happy thoughts, Duffy.
Thank you.
that Professor Duffy?
Yeah. He didn't make it. I know this looks bad. And I'm not gonna lie, it is. But, I did successfully save the Winnebago. Also, I'm really sorry about what I said earlier. I didn't mean it. We're all in this together, and without you guys, I definitely would have made it this far tonight. So, thanks. Oh, God. Ugh. Was I holding that the whole time?
Casper, you have a little brain on your face.
Brain? Where? Here? Where
it's pretty big.
Yeah, it's all over. There's a little more.
Check out this old photo, Casper. Looks like you.
Yeah.
We even know where he's buried, but that's all we could dig up.
Dig up, that's it.
What?
The missing element, a pocket watch. He's got his very own timepiece.
And
Graham said something about my great-grandfather before he died. Something about, I don't know. It seemed like gibberish, but it's not. You said he's buried?
Yeah.
Exactly. He's buried with the pocket watch. That's what my Gramps was trying to tell me. We gotta go dig up my great-grandfather. Like, literally, tonight with shovels.
Where to?
Dagger Cliff Cemetery.
Step on it, Seth.
A cemetery in the middle of a Zeman curse. That's comforting.
Hey, Daz, what are you doing?
I'm taking in the scenery. What's it look like?
It looks like you're about to jump out the window.
Yeah! Jump, I say!
No, Razzle! Don't even think about it!
Let me go!
Don't do it! What the hell are you doing?
Okay. Okay, my skull adventure didn't go so smooth. There were Zemans everywhere, and the skull wasn't where it was supposed to be. Finally, I found these Zemans playing football, using the skull as a ball. The Zeman QB saw me and hurled the bomb. I caught it, and I just started running.
What's not so smooth about that?
I got greedy, Becky. Even Tiffany was watching, really into my catch. But I remembered the whole seducing thing, so I decided I'd give it a shot. I thought I was in control, but then she was seducing me. The tongue started going all crazy and shit, and then bam! She gave me a dickie! And I was like, damn, Zeman Tiffany, you just gave me a dickie!
Wait, a dickie?
Yeah, a dick hickey.
Right, continue.
So I grabbed the bitch by her titties, and I threw her as far as I could. I called them my titty dolls. Zeman started chasing me. And well, you know the rest. Now all I can think about is killing myself.
No! Stop that! Stop it right now!
Stop that!
I told you I can't help it. Guys, suddenly I got really scared.
Don't worry, Daz. We're not gonna let you kill yourself.
Okay. Okay. Hey, is there any ointment in here? My dickie's burning real bad.
Smell.
Strong heart, check. Earn, check. Ashes, check. Guys, there's only one element left.
If you were to tell me we'd be digging up my great-grandfather today. Okay, but Gramps is actually gone.
Your grandpa really believed in you. I do too.
You do?
Yeah. I think you're really special.
Hey, Lucy. I need you to forgive me.
For what?
For this.
I just can't help myself now! Hell, I'm out of the Barbie!
Suicidal maniac, get coming!
Yeah! He's going for the axe!
Ah! Oh, I just clocked my best friend in the face with the shovel. I just hit the casket.
Guys, I'd like to announce that I'm officially no longer hungry.
Gilbert, it's your great-grandson. I'm sorry we're meeting under such uncomfortable circumstances.
Wait! Bird? Is that supposed to be a poem?
Stand back, everyone. Looks like another job for the Zeman seducer.
Hey there, Zeman birdie.
Stop that right now. You should be ashamed of yourself just waltzing in here, giving Lucy of all girls a hickey, and then just screaming and acting like a simpleton.
Did it work? You did really good. That was actually really...
Yeah,
you had an impressive move going in. It was really good.
I tried really hard.
You did great.
Bert, listen, I'm going through a lot right now, and if you really love me, I need you to just give me some space.
No!
I know what they are. I'm gonna need you to just go. Please, just go away.
Sorry. I think I'm gonna go now.
No. Don't go.
You'll always have the toad.
Don't say that, Lucy. You're gonna be fine here.
We have to go.
You can do what you want, but I'm gonna stay here forever.
Seth, she's gonna turn into a Zeman.
It's not Lucy anymore, okay?
Sure it is. Hi, Lucy. Hi.
Seth. Oh! Oh!
Wait! I learned from the best. Pucker up, hot lips. Time to seduce and enslave. I'm going in!
Odo.
Yeah. It's working! I knew it was working!
Raise your hand.
It worked.
You and Zeman Slate. Guys. Guys, check it out. I'd like to introduce you to my new main squeezeroo. Zeman Slave Lucy. I think we're going steady.
That's real sweet, but can we go now?
Guys? Where's Daz?
up in the tree with the bees.
Not the bees, Daz! You're allergic! You're allergic to bees!
Deathly allergic! But I already told you I can't help myself!
Why
the bees? My eyes and my nose! Oh, my nose! And my ears! Anything but the bees! The bees! Promise me you pull that shit.
The sun's almost up. We don't hurry. We're gonna be cursed for eternity.
We have to deal with Daz, Casper. I mean, he knows the plan, and when he turns into a Zeman, he'll do anything to stop us.
I can try and seduce him. It's too risky, and it's disgusting.
Thank God you said that. It would be very awkward, and socially,
you know what? Just go to the Winnebago and ready the elements.
Okay.
Take care of Daz.
Are you sure?
Stars. You did the right thing.
All right. In you go.
Hold you.
All right.
Everything's all set.
All right. I took care of this.
Okay. So, according to the book, we have to put all of the elements inside the urn and seal it with the skull. Okay.
Where's the urn?
The urn. Lucy had it last, right?
Well, oh.
Oh. God, it's what Daz broke over her head. It's in a million pieces on the ground.
Does it have an urn?
Awesome.
Well, what now?
Seth, you were right.
I was?
Never know when you're gonna need a hot dog, Mark.
A wiener urn.
All right, everyone grab an item.
Okay.
First, we're gonna need the ashes.
Yes, got it.
Okay, then followed by the toad heart.
Okay.
Next, we need the pocket watch to reverse the hands of time.
Got it.
And finally, the human skull to seal the urn.
Okay, cork it up, Cass.
Got it, you ready?
This is it. Please work, Mr. Hunt, tuck my urn. Oh,
It totally did!
Guys, Lucy's still a Zeman.
Yay.
Oh. We don't have time for this. What are we supposed to do?
Wait, something else is burning into the book.
What?
It's an asterisk.
Oh, I hate those things.
What does it say?
Okay. To reverse the curse and release your strife, one of the cursed must...
Must what? What do we have to do?
What? Must sacrifice your own life.
Wait, one of us has to kill ourselves?
This is crazy. There's gotta be. There has to be another way.
Yeah. We're running out of time. There's
gotta be something.
Wait, Casper!
Dawn's almost here.
I'm doing it.
No.
We're running out of time, and I was the one who got us in this mess in the first place.
Casper, we're all to blame. I'm not letting you do this.
I have to. Everything's gonna be fine, okay? I promise. Please. Seth, you take care of the ladies, and, my best to you and Lucy. I know. Something to remember me by. It's great getting to know you tonight.
Is this me?
It's supposed to be cute, no weird.
It's perfect.
Thanks. Okay.
Casper, you gonna kill yourself with a rolling pin?
Right.
Crossbow?
You got any better ideas, Seth?
Right.
That'll work. It's really gonna work.
It's gonna be great.
Take care of the paddy wing.
You did it, Cass, man. You saved the day.
That's nice.
I'm so proud of Casper. The pictures are gone.
Yeah, Cass, everything's back to normal. Nothing's changed.
Almost nothing.
Really?
Yeah, whatever.
Now you've got your story for Duffy, Cass.
Oh, Casper, sweetie, you look so handsome walking across that stage. Your father would be so proud.
Thanks, Mom.
Big news, guys. I'm expanding my online mug empire, and I just brought on a brand new partner.
I'm responsible for giving the web layout a more seductive touch.
Yes, you are.
And here you are, Mr. Galloway.
Yes, I would have given you an A. I just found the whole Zeman thing a little far-fetched. Though I did love the bit with the exhaust pipe. Wonderful and charming. Good luck. You're my 38th favorite suit.
Thank you, Duffy.
Good luck with your future.
Oh, Mrs. Galloway, would you mind taking a photo?
Oh, I would love to.
Thank you.
Oh, wait for me! Oh. Sorry, guys, I'm just getting a dip.
Say meatballs!
Meatballs!
Lock and load.
Oh, I'll get my skirt.
Ready?
Yes.
Right.
Yeah. Oh, Casper, check it out.
Listen, ladies. Paddy Wagon isn't in the threesomes anymore, so let's say you grab a friend, we go four-way, all the way.
What a loser.
I know. Oh. I
should hold
it there. Let's go!
Let's go!
Yeah!
Make it. I didn't have anybody to watch the shop.
That's actually why we're here.
Well, now that we're graduates, we were hoping that we could be faithful employees of the occult barn.
Really? Mm-hmm. You two will watch the shop.
We have to pay for our new place somehow.
It's a big place.
Oh, that's great news. Oh.
Where are you going?
Vacation! I waited 50 years for this. You remember the ground rule?
Don't close during open hours, lock up when you leave, and don't come in spinning distance of the urn.
And?
Yep, and your prize trophy.
You got it. Aloha, kiddos. I'll send you a postcard. Ha!
Well, he sure looks happy.
He's not the only one. You trying to give me a hickey?
Oh! Oh!
We're so dead.
Screaming for the the screaming. So loud the pain of a new day to cross their path, reverse their curse, bring life back to normal so it no longer hurts, and make some suicidal thoughts come to reality. But first, Mr. Galloway's half away from the end of the world's worst case of demons combined with zombies, forming armies to take over families and raise an amok until someone gets heavy. But now it's almost too late to stop the fire, to stay safe and protected from the demons in the night. What the hell is a semen? Half zombie, half demon. Casper's treading in the deep end. What the hell is a semen? Half zombie, half demon. Protect yourself and help the others grieve. What the hell is a semen? Half zombie, half demon. Casper's treading in that deep end. What the hell is a semen? Half zombie, half demon. What the hell? There is still a chance of hope for this crew on a mission as they deliver their vision to finish the killings of victims by self-inflicted innocent actions brought forth by these young kids living in accident. Of course, from what was the norm, like graduated from school, instead they protect their friends from these monsters around you, to eventually making the city happy, then back to when it was fun to hang with buddies, foes, and loved ones, joke around and spend tons of time being a kid. Now that's the brink of coming to an end. The journey's getting to be a bit difficult to manage with only him and his friends. He's made it this far. We grew up, we grew on, and now it's time for Casper to succeed until he's dead before dawn. What the hell is a semen? Half zombie, half demon. What the hell is a semen? What the hell is a semen? Half zombie, half demon.